Hello everyone! Again, you can watch me create a nice resin flower cupcake stand in this video, but this time the flower shapes will be a little bit larger, and to create some nice effects that I like so much, I'm going to use the puddle technique again. I'm also going to experiment with mica pigments in my puddle pour. So I'm very curious how that will work out, and because normally I only use pastes in the puddles. The colors I'm going to use are pink and a little bit gold, but also some glitter. Also on the front side, so the side I pour that you see now, I'm going to add something that I think will give me a nice look. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin, in this case, but I also have tutorials of acrylic art and alcohol ink, mixed media and a lot more, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because if you select all, then you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So the shapes are a little bit larger. This one I got from Molds and Shapes. And it's the largest flower shape they have. They call it XL or XL. So it's very large. And so that will be my base shape. And the other shapes I'm going to make with another flower shape. It's their middle size. And I'm also going to use the flower shape that you can, that is in the coaster holder. So I'm going to use the three different silicon molds. So this is the largest one. So on the outside I poured one of my own natural mica pigments, it's the cotton candy. And in the middle I poured the alcohol ink pinata, the Señorita Magenta. And now I'm using my embossing tool to remove air bubbles. I'm using the Art Pro resin. I think it's an amazing resin. So I'm starting the puddle technique, and the first color is also one of my own natural mica pigments. It's the White Lily, and I never use mica pigments in the puddle. So I want to see how that works and if I can create a nice look. So on top I poured some alcohol ink, Señorita Magenta. On top of that I've used the white Casting Craft paste, and I added a few drops of the Señorita Magenta to color it to a nice pink shade. Again the White Lily, there you can see it, nice natural mica pigment. There's a nice pearly shine. And on top of that, some alcohol ink, Señorita Magenta, only a small puddle. And there you can see it, I colored the white paste with a few drops of the alcohol ink to give it a nice pink color. And on top of that, the white paste. So hopefully I can create some nice effects on the bottom side of the flower. So a lot of experiments, but I like to experiment and show it to you all. Yeah, I'm not going to fill the mold all the way to the top, because I want to add something on top of this to create another look. Again, my embossing tool, and I must say the Art Pro resin from Resin Pro has not a lot of air bubbles. You can pour up to 1 centimeter with it, so that's great. So in the middle I'm using the Sparkle White, also one of my natural mica pigments. If you're interested in my pigments. All the information is in the description box. They are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. Also, the link to her Etsy shop is in the description box. And we have some nice discounts. If you want more info about that, then you only need to look at the description box of the pigment. Then you can get 10%, 15% or 20% discount. So that's great. So if you're interested, please check out the description box. So I added some gold leaf in the middle. And on top, the sparkle white. So I'm almost done with the largest shape, so my base flower shape. Last time the embossing tool for the air bubbles. Yeah, the resin is dry. Now I'm going to add a second layer. So I'm starting with some clear, because I mentioned that I didn't pour all the way up to the top of the silicone mold, because I want to add something on top of this layer to give it a nice look. So I'm starting with some clear. And what I already mentioned, I'm using the ArtPro resin from Resin Pro. If you are interested in this resin, the link is in the description box. And I also have a promo code for this resin company. If you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount. So that's great. And you can use it for all their websites. Not only the German or the UK one, also the France, Spain, Italy, Russia. So it's my promo code is working for all those websites. So again, I'm going to add some gold leaf. There you can see it. Into the clear. You will not see it on the bottom side. But I already added some gold leaf in the first layer. So I want to create the front side a totally different look than hopefully a nice bottom or backside. Spreading the gold leaf with a stirring stick, and it dried very nice. Yeah, and I'm going to add lines of the rich gold. It's also a powder pigment from Resin Pro. It's a very nice powder pigment because it floats on top. So I'm going to add some lines because I want to have a nice flower look. So with my stirring stick, I dip into the gold and I add it into the clear. There you can see it. And I want to have a nice center. So I'm adding some black glitter and gold glass glitter. I mixed it together in a little bit of resin. And that will be my center. I think that is a nice contrast. So also this you will not see on the bottom side. Again, I'm adding some lines of the gold. This is a really great gold. So also the link to this powder pigment is in the description box. Just as all my other supplies I've used. I always list them at the end of the video, but I also add all the links, website links, in the description box. You can see I also drag some of the gold leaf into the petals of the flower. I think that will look nice. Adding the rest of the clear resin. Yeah, I'm using the silicon molds of Molds and Shapes, as I already mentioned, and they are great quality molds. The link to their Facebook page is in the description box, so if you're interested in these silicon molds, then the only thing you need to do is go to that Facebook page and send them a message through that Facebook page, and then it will all be okay. But they are great quality silicon molds. I am very impressed by these molds. So now I'm also adding some of the glitter mix to define those petals a little bit better. There you can see it. Then I think it really gets the look of a flower. And I'm still working on the base flower shape. And I'm going to start on the middle shape. Again, on the outside. The cotton candy, one of my own natural mica pigments, and there you can see on the left side, that's normally the silicon mold for the coaster holder, but I'm using it for my smallest flower shape. And I also want to take the time to thank my monthly sponsors, Evelyn, for sending me such nice supplies, and Dolores and Laurie to sponsor me every month. I appreciate so much. Michelle, also thank you so much. And of course, Molds and Shapes for sending me these amazing molds. And also Resin Pro Company for having such great supplies, because I like them very much. In the beginning I used Stone Coat, but the Stone Coat company is based in the USA and they don't ship anymore to the Netherlands, so I needed to search for a comparing resin, and this resin is just as good as the Stone Coat resin, so I'm very pleased with all their supplies. Again, I'm using the Signorita Magenta to fill the mold, using the embossing tool to remove some air bubbles. So I never use a torch, because if you use a torch, the heat of the flame is very hot, so then you have the risk that your resin will stick to the silicon mold. Again, I'm starting with the White Lily, the mica pigment, the experiment, what I told you. On top, some of the alcohol ink. And I do the same as the large shape I already made. On top of that, a mixture of the white paste with a few drops of the alcohol ink. to give it a nice pink shade. And on top of that, the white paste. And that way you can build up your puddle and push the colors to the outside and to the bottom. And I also want to mention that I started some nice projects, and also a project where I use an engraved mold. So I never done that before. So Molds and Shapes sent me their test mold. So I'm working on that project. And also upcoming is a detailed resin project. I made a few before that one. I made a mouth and an eye and an owl. So this time I'm going to make some resin butterflies, and with some cherry blossom in the background. So it's a detailed resin project, and it's I need to make it in more phases. So that will be a larger project, and in which I make several videos, so not one. So that's our upcoming projects. And I also have something in mind with some acrylic pours again. So a lot is coming up. So I made the puddles larger by adding all those colors. And hopefully I will get a nice bottom side. Yeah, I want to have the mold filled a little bit more with resin. That's why I'm adding more to the puddle. Yeah, and I also want to thank all the people that participated in my 20k giveaway. All the winners, the three winners, have sent me an email. So hopefully they will like their prize. And in the future I will be for sure doing more giveaways, because I think I'm reaching 25k now. So that's great. But I will do a giveaway if I have 30k, so 5k to go, and then I will do a giveaway again, because I like giving things away. So please share my videos as much as you can, because then I will reach the 30k much faster. But thank you so much for participating. And for all your nice comments, I appreciate it very much. So again, I'm going to add some gold leaf in the centers. There you can see it on top, the sparkle white. It's an amazing pigment, the sparkle white. It just looks like glitter, but it's not, what I already mentioned in previous videos. But it gives a nice sparkle. You can also add it in your other colors to give it more sparkle. But I like this pigment very much. So I'm almost done, and then I need to let this dry before I can work on it again. So we are 24 hours later, and so you can see it dried much brighter. I like it very much. So I'm starting in the middle with the glitter mix again, what I also did with the large shape. So it's a mix of black glitter with some golden glass glitter. So in the center. And around it I'm pouring some clear resin. And also, this cupcake stand will get a food safe layer. Yeah, I get a lot of questions about food safe. If it's, yeah, some people question it. But if you want to know more about this resin, the link is in the description box. And go to their website and you can read the description of the resin. But I never add any pigments in this food safe resin. But it will get a clear layer of food safe resin. So again, I'm going to add some gold leaf. There you can see it. Because I need to match it with the other shape, with the large shape I already made. So that's why I'm adding the gold leaf around the dark center. Also, the smallest flower shape. Yeah, this video is also a little bit longer than I normally have because yeah, I want to show you as much as I can from the whole process. Yeah, and on the edge I'm going to add the same gold as I did with the larger shape. Now only on the edge, there you can see it, and hopefully if I pour the clear next to it, it will flow into the clear so that I get a nice golden look on top. Yes, I'm using my stirring stick to push it against the silicon mold. There you can see it. But I don't want to add too much because I don't want to have the front side totally gold. So hopefully this is not too much. Adding more of the clear so that the gold can flow into the clear. Pushing the clear against the gold. Again, some glitter lines to define the petals a little bit better. And you can already see that the gold is starting to float on top of the clear. Floats to the inside. And that's what I want. Also, the same with the middle size flower shape. Again, the gold on the edge, not too much. And if you look closely to the smaller shape, the gold is going to the inside. Hopefully not all the way, but yeah, you never know. This is also an experiment to see if it works or not. Again, I'm going to add some clear, but I also did with a smaller shape. And let the gold bleed into the clear. Pushing it against each other with my stirring stick. I like the look of the smaller shape. The gold looks very nice. At the end of this video, I show you a close-up of the front side, but also the bottom or the back side. And hopefully I have totally different looks on both sides, so that the customer or the client can choose which side it's going to use. Again, some glitter lines. There you can see it. And then I'm almost done with these flower shapes, the middle one and the smaller one. Yeah, this is the large one again, so I'm also going to add some gold on the edge of the largest shape. And it dried very well. You can see the middle part is amazing. I think it looks like a nice flower. It has some depth. That's great. Also some clear to let the gold flow into the clear, because I want to create the same look as the other two flower shapes. And if you pour these molds all the way to the top, then it's about 1 centimeter thick. So that's great. And then I'm almost done with these flower shapes. Then I need to let it, of course, dry before I can take them out of the mold. So we are 1 hour later, and I really want to show you the effect that I got from the gold. It's really nice. It floats on top and the pink color is shining through, so I like it very much. Let me know what you think of the front side. In the close-up you can see it much better, but the gold is amazing. And I also like the dark center with the lines. Gives a nice contrast. They are the large base flower shape. Yeah, I'm very pleased so far. Hopefully it will stay this way. So we are 24 hours later. Now I can take them out of the mold. So I'm starting with a large one, the large flower. And it looks amazing. I like this side very much. I have some a nice golden border or an edge, and the gold on top is amazing. Yeah, I'm very pleased. Hopefully you all like this also. Please let me know in the comments below this video. So that one is out of the mold. Now the other two. This is the middle size. And normally I don't have any problems taking them out of the mold. So now we can take a closer look. There you can hopefully see the nice gold and the back side. Also nice, totally different, but I like this also. So again, you can use it on both sides. Very nice. So my experiment with the mica pigments in the puddle, yeah, I think it was a success. And the large one, yeah, it's, yeah, I'm liking this one, very nice. Also like the large flower shape as my base. A closer look now. This is the bottom or the backside with the nice effects and the gold leaf. And you can see a little bit of the black glitter with a nice soft pink edge. So let me know which side you like the most. The front or the back. I like them both. I can't choose. I like them very much. Nice sparkly center. Great effects. And this is the front side, how I poured it. There you can see that the gold is floating on top. I like it very much. This pigment is amazing. It's a totally different look, but both are nice. So this is the end result of the front, so how I poured it with the gold floating on top. Yeah, I'm very happy with the end result. So let me know what you think, if you like the front or the back. I like them both. I can't choose, but I had so much fun making this. The experiments worked with the glitter on top and the gold pigment. So all the supplies I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box. There's a lot of information in the description box. Also all the promo codes I have, what I already mentioned from the Resin Pro company. If you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount. Also a German website, resinkunst.de. If you use my code Petra10, then you can also 10% discount. And this website sells Elichem supplies. So, and I also am an affiliate of Jackson's Art Supply, a UK-based company where you can buy a lot of art materials. If you are new there and you place your order, then you get also 10% discount. But then you need to use the links in the description box. So this is the bottom side. I also like this side. So I think it looks great, and my experiments worked. I for sure will experiment with it a little bit more. But so far I'm very happy with the end result. I want to thank you all for watching again, and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye!